Please close your eyes and answer for yourself a few questions that I raise. Which people in your life are your most loved people? And imagine that one of them is ill. It's about he's about or she's about to die. What do you feel? What do you do? And then imagine that it's war. You can't be with her or him. And he's already dead or in prison. How do you feel? Millions of people feel what you feel now every day. Sadness, insecurity, fear, being alone every day. Their family, their friends, their neighbors are dying. In the name of what? And the number of wars are rising at this moment. And we send people, and what is the answer? We send people, ambassadors, investigators, they look. We send military forces. They go there, who's right, who's wrong? It's quite difficult to know who's right, who's wrong, and who to protect and who to defend. And at the end, nothing changes. We spent only this year worldwide $1.54 trillion. Can you imagine? $1.54 trillion to buy weaponry. And the interesting question is, who is to blame? The world leaders? Politics, businesses, money, religion, civil society, we? Because we also let it happen. So we are also part of the problem and part of the solution. Like Desmond Tutu, one of our ambassadors, said, world leaders cannot push back armed conflicts alone. We need the whole world to make this happen. We need to shift in our thinking and our acting. We need to shift from people with power to power with the people. And then two friends, Ilko van der Linde from the Netherlands and one guy from Egypt, Mohammed Helmi, they thought about it like this and he said, let's act. So they started in 2010, they started Masterpiece. Masterpiece is an innovative, bottom-up, global peace movement. And we try to bring opposites together and to prevent armed conflicts. And we ask everybody to put their talents and to use their energy to build for peace and togetherness. And in 3 years' time, so we hit something, in 3 years' time, we now have thousands and thousands of volunteers, schools, universities, cities, mayors, the United Nations, small and big companies. Recently, MTV and Google joined us as partners, very important because they're right in the target group. And we feel that, especially in the conflict areas, they're even more eager. We have now 46 masterpiece clubs worldwide, from Afghanistan to Colombia and from Sierra Leone to Russia, that make their own peace projects because they know better than everybody in the world that they don't want to wait any longer for their political leaders to bring peace. They realize that they are the key to peace. And I think if everybody realizes that, then we can make that shift because nobody can do everything, but everybody can do something. And you too, we need you too. And you too. And you too. And you there. This guy with these glasses. Or there are more guys with glasses there, but We need you too. The growth is special because it's local leaders, local entrepreneurs, local heroes that we found, and they're all self-supporting. So we don't give them money. We support them by showing how important social media are, how important it is to make pictures, to make videos, to show the world what is happening. We give some trainings about conflict prevention, and most important, that they feel that they're part of a global movement and that we support them and that they're not alone. So it's nice to see. They send now lots of pictures all the time, but I made a selection of a few just to give you an example of what's happening all over the world. So this is in Nepal. This is in Uganda. Fantastic. Bangladesh, Afghanistan, Congo, Iraq, Sierra Leone, Philippines, the Netherlands, of course, Lebanon, Tanzania, Indonesia, Egypt, Maasai. What we decided with all these masterpiece clubs together, we decided to have our coming most important date, that's the Day of Peace, the 23rd of September next year, 2014. We decided that from sunrise to sundown, we organize in all these countries fantastic, unforgettable concerts with the top, so every country is also challenged to ask their top most known famous musician to be part of that event and to also invite the leaders of that country to invite for that event. And so you can see by internet 24 hours everything, all these events that happening all over the world. And I, of course, want to be there. And I hope you want to be there too. But remember that it's a Just Do It campaign for peace. And there are no tickets for sale. You can earn it by doing yourself something for peace. Then you get the tickets. You can go to the platform. There you meet other peace builders and projects. And please go there. And also necessary to end with is that we, of course, think with each other about the structural impact that we have with these activities. Because we do need peace builders now, but even more to prevent coming violence and wars. So we decided our next aim is 2020. Then we make sure that we have 500,000 of bridge builders, peace builders all over the world, ready to prevent escalation. And I feel that if you build something together, that's the best answer for a better world. And this guy, he inspired me a lot. Emil Katako, that's his name. And these are eggs, 6 eggs. And I was with him, and he said, eggs are like peace. They're vital for us. My village, my family, myself, we live for it, we need it. But they're very vulnerable. I have to handle it with care. And if I run too hard, they break. And if I put too many in the basket, they break as well. That's also with peace. We need time, patience, and love to get real peace in this village, in my village. And then he said, I give you my eggs. Please bring them with you if you talk about peace. So I take care of my village, and you tell the world. So the message is, of course, share your eggs, your ideas, your enthusiasm, your love, because you're important. You make the difference. And you always did. So don't applaud for me, but applaud for yourself at the moment that you realize and that you decide to do something for peace. Thank you very much.